Good morning. I am just getting ready to go to a photo shoot today. I can't tell you what the photo shoot's for, you know, the whole client blah 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 thing. But we're doing a shoot this morning, and then we'll come back and we'll do some work. It's Thursday. It's supposed to rain today in LA. Don't worry, I'm not driving my car. It's all good. I'm just sitting in my driveway before I gotta go, which is right now. So I just wanted to say hi, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time it is that you're watching this. Exciting day today because of the photo shoot and then because of the rain. Totally excited. My neighbors think I'm crazy because I'm in my car talking to a camera. Okay, I gotta go. I'll check in a little bit.
2 hours later.
All right, guys, I just got back home from the shoot. It went really well. Sitting in the office now, I got my to-do list, things to do. It's raining outside.
Oh my god.
Honey?
No!
Honey, what is it?
It's raining! They didn't warn us! What are we gonna do?
Check Twitter!
I'm gonna get cracking and do some work. Hopefully later today we can do some art and create something. It's my goal every day, is to do a little bit of art every single day.
Later.
I wanted to have a conversation about style, because style as an artist is super important, and there's a difference, I think, in developing a commercial style and then being creative and being artistic. There's a lot of great artists that have their style. Photographers like Annie Leibovitz or the illustrator Kim Jung-ji, amazing illustrator. There's an artist here in LA, I only know him by The Art of Chase. All of these people have their developed commercial style. As an artist, as what I like to call myself, an emerging artist, I'm still figuring out my style. When I look back at journals that I have and the illustrations that I've posted, like the ones that we framed the other day, I definitely have a style. But I look at all these other great people and I follow all these amazing artists on Instagram and I want their style. I want to draw like they do. I want to draw like the guy who draws the Berenstain Bears. I'll put his name right there when I look it up online. I want to draw like this artist I met the other night, and she drew this dope, I'll take it out so you can see it. She drew this dope portrait of me. I love her style. I want to copy her style. I think it's dope. And that's a struggle that I have as an artist, is that I always want to duplicate what I see. I see something dope and I want to do that. Well, a long time ago, I had this epiphany about music. I love music. I think music is the greatest thing ever. It's an art. It's meditative, it's relaxing, it's connection between people, it connects communities, and I wanted to make music. My personality is, I want to do everything. I want to be a musician, I want to be an artist, I want to be a photographer, I want to be a videographer, be a chef, be an architect, design computer games, direct commercials, like I want to do everything. And there was a moment, be it a small time, I wanted to be a musician. It's because of my love for music. My mom made me play piano growing up and I hated it, but now I look back and I'm so grateful that I had that experience because I understand music in a broader sense. And the epiphany that I had with music is this: I can appreciate music on a deeper level, but that doesn't mean I have to make music, right? So I'm gonna leave the music up to the professionals and let them do their thing. I'm not going to invest time and energy and effort into learning music. Every time I get to listen to music, which I listen to music all day long, I'm gonna have that deep appreciation for it. Now, take that into the art spectrum. I feel like my photography definitely has a style. It's crisp, it's clean, it's colorful. it's composed in a certain way, it makes sense. I'm still figuring out my style in art. Definitely am finding my style and learning my style, but it's not commercially viable yet. Now, part of me is grateful for that because I don't want to be a sellout, but the other part of me wants to be an artist and get paid to be an artist. So I have to kind of find that style. Do you know what I'm saying? So that's just kind of what I was thinking tonight. But now I'm just gonna chill out and I'm going to draw on the computer. We'll talk more about why I'm putting videos on YouTube in case you're curious. But for like the 20 people that have been watching my videos on YouTube, thank you. I appreciate it. And if you haven't yet, just hit that little subscribe button and the ring bell button and yeah, right? Isn't that, leave a comment? Okay, thanks for watching. I will see you next week because I'm gonna take the weekend off and spend time with my family. Enjoy the drawing, make the world a more beautiful place, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye. Okay, I hope you can hear me. I'm using Photo Booth to record this. So I thought I was recording my screen and doing a video of me drawing, but it didn't work out. So I'm using an older video of me drawing something that says Markle. What is Markle? You'll just have to wait and find out. I didn't mean to put it in this video, but I wanted to show you some kind of time-lapse video of me drawing. So it's in here. It's almost 2 a.m. I'm going to put this video in, put that video in, put some music, export it, upload it, go to bed, share it with you all. Yeah. I'm so tired. This YouTube business is no joke. Okay, here's the video. Anyway, okay. Healing all the broken, I hear it now.